I could have put this on my channel on death and dying, which I'll put a link to in the low bar just in case anyone is interested. But I wouldn't put a video on Halloween on my channel on death and dying. So I don't see why this shouldn't come here. I think, as with anything one does, there are overlaps anyway, and I think this is an interesting topic because the Day of the Dead, which is celebrated in parts of the world, notably Mexico and surrounding areas, but it is a completely different attitude and outlook towards death. It celebrates the life of people's relatives in a joyful way. Their favourite foods are prepared. Skulls, as you will see from the images here, are presented in a colourful way. In a way that we in the West might find, well, they are in the West, so that's a stupid statement, but you know what I mean. We in the more anally retentive world might find quite shocking because it lacks the somber, serious, black and white attitude towards death and dying. And I think there is a place, of course, for our general attitude towards it. No, losing people is sad. Dying usually is painful, sometimes in a prolonged way. It's not the pleasantest of experience for the majority of people. But because of that, we tend to end up at one end of the spectrum regarding it and ignoring the other end. And people who celebrate this day do also grieve the loss of people. It's not just a time of great jollification. But I do think that we would do well to start looking at the various aspects of dying and of loss and of the fact that somebody is no more in the physical. I don't say that in a spiritual sense. I mean in the sense that, anybody who I have lost during my life that I have been particularly close to is still tangible in my thoughts and in my emotions, in my memories. They're still very real to me. I still think about both my parents often in a happy way, in a sense of thinking about what they might have said about a particular situation or how they might have advised me if I'd have asked them for it, or things that they may have got pleasure from, things that might have touched them. Not in a an obsessive way, but it does pass through my mind, and I don't see anything wrong with that. So I think we would do well to start embracing some of the traditions that exist in cultures which in some ways are much healthier than ours. Not in all ways. I mean, I think, all cultures have things to learn from one another. And I think we definitely have something to learn from the Day of the Dead and the way it is presented. I mean, they make sugar skulls that you can eat. And how shocking would that be in our society? We have Halloween, which is a kind of jokey, macabre, poke at death rather than a memory of those lost. So, what do you think? What do you think?